In my last video, I talked about how much of the modern left, the parts you find in mainstream media, in HR departments, in social media, in Hollywood, and some other places, on college campuses and such, focus on identity politics, or more accurately, the progressive stack, as a method of somehow taking care of class supremacy. It's this notion that focusing on identity politics will somehow solve class supremacy. It doesn't. As I said, it's as stupid as Republicans thinking that if you give rich people more money, it'll just trickle down to the poor. Yeah, it just doesn't work. Trickle up can work, because when poor people have money, they spend it. When they have the means, they spend it. They don't hoard it, which in turn helps the whole country. This is why I support universal basic income. If we want to at least reduce the negative effects of class supremacy, we have to help out everyone. We have to take care of everyone. And you don't achieve that through the progressive stack. We do have a serious problem with racism in this country. The historical, colloquial, and dictionary definition, as well as the new progressive definition. I have to laugh when people call the historical, colloquial, and dictionary definition as a right-wing definition. I had a long argument with someone in the comment section of one of my last videos about that. It's like, no, honey, that's not the right-wing definition. The new definition is the progressive definition, since most people don't use that new definition, and it's not in most dictionaries. The new definition is not the standard, and I hope it never becomes the standard. I mean, if you want to talk about institutional racism, systemic racism, then just add a word before it, so you know what type of racism it is. Or you could just say, a system of racism. But to just redefine racism all around is stupid, I'm sorry. Well, I shouldn't say I'm sorry if I'm not actually sorry, right? Anyway, the most significant problem when it comes to racism in this country is how black people are treated by the police. As I've said before, we need to abolish the practice of police profiling people when they haven't actually done anything, when they're just looking around for a potential criminal. They shouldn't be allowed to profile people when they're not looking for a specific criminal. If they're looking for a specific criminal, a crime has been committed, fine, do profiling, it's necessary. But not when you're not already looking for someone who has already committed a crime. It's not right. But the biggest thing that needs to stop is the use of unnecessary force. We need to put an end to police brutality, or at least seriously reduce it. Police brutality affects everyone. But it disproportionately affects black people because of the way that black people get profiled. I mean, being pulled over for speeding on the freeway shouldn't be a death sentence. As it's been said, you know, a white person gets pulled over, you don't have to think of all these rules. Okay, keep your hands solely on the wheel, don't reach for your registration, you know, and just, like, be scared of the officer. Because if you make even the slightest wrong move, you're shot. Yet white people don't have to worry about that. Black people do because police are profiling them as being potential criminals, even for things as simple as speeding on the freeway. Some people argue that, oh, but police have such a dangerous job. It's one of the most dangerous jobs out there. It's like, no, it isn't really that dangerous when you compare it to a number of other jobs. It doesn't even make it into the top 10 most dangerous common jobs. For instance, logging is 11 times more deadly than being a police officer. Not 11%, no, 11 times more deadly than being a police officer. It's that much more dangerous. So yes, we can certainly significantly reduce how lethal cops are. This is within our reach. You don't achieve this by reducing officers' pay or reducing the number of officers that are out there on the streets. You achieve this by changing the standards, changing their training, by disallowing police departments from moving corrupt police officers around the same way that, you know, the Catholic Church moves pedophile priests around. If we reduce how lethal cops are allowed to be, then the cops who are racist will have a much less negative effect on the black community. I mean, we can't just wave our hands and racism just kind of disappears. We can't guilt trip people into not being racist. Racism is unfortunately part of the fabric of this country. And really the best things that we can do is, one, try to reduce the negative effects of racism. And the other is to reasonably educate. Reasonably. Critical race theory is not the way to achieve that goal. The crap that comes from people like Robin DiAngelo in White Fragility, yeah, that's not the way to go about it. Okay, that just divides people more. And no, I'm not just judging her book on what other people say about it. I read the book. I made a video about her book. Okay, I think it's terrible. But this is the kind of thing that's being promoted in HR departments. People are expected to sit through seminars about this. And no, that's not helping. You're not helping anything by pushing these notions. It's divisive. Okay, looking at people as people is the key. I mean, no, we can't truly know what black people's experiences are. We can listen to black people when they talk about it, but we're never going to really know what it's like to be black. You know, the best we can do is try to look at people as people. You know, stop looking at someone as a criminal just because they're black. Stop it. We need to stop that. And for decades, the notion of trying to be more colorblind and looking at people as people was working. Things were getting better and better. But in recent years, people have suddenly decided that the messages that come from Martin Luther King are wrong, that they're not good enough, that they're insufficient. Because along with his messages about race and saying how important it is for people to look at people for the quality of their character instead of the color of their skin, we also abandoned other things that Martin Luther King was pushing, like the Poor People's Campaign. As I suggested earlier in this video, if we do what we can to try to reduce class supremacy, many of the issues that revolve around identity politics will be tackled along with it. Not all of them, but it will take a significant chunk out of it. You know, at that point, then we can maybe tackle identity politics issues, since they won't be nearly as significant as they are now. Again, trickle up can work. Trickle down cannot. Giving people special privileges because they belong to a racial group, or they belong to a gender group, or they're within the LGBT demographic, yeah, that's not the answer. Let's try to find solutions that actually have a chance of working, instead of just dividing the country more. We can see that this division is not working. We need to try something else. I guess that's all I've got to say. Thanks for watching.